680's Richard Southern joins us. Richard, PC leader Doug Ford is promising to knock 10 cents off the price at the pumps. Now, he's also warning that gas will actually hit $2 a litre if the Liberals or NDP win the election. So you are fact-checking and putting Ford's claims to the test.
Yeah, and I knew it would only be a matter of time, Francis, before the gas price issue emerged on the campaign trail. I mean, we're paying a 40-year high right now. So indeed, Mr. Ford promising to knock 10 cents a litre off the price. He says he'd do that by eliminating the cap and trade tax that went into place here provincially just over a year ago. He also said he would reduce the provincial fuel tax by 5.7 cents. So would this actually result in a lower price of gas? We asked Roger McKnight, our gas price expert.
It will in fact do that if he can do it, but I don't think he can do it. I think if I was him, I would look at the HST portion. At today's prices, the HST portion is 16 cents a liter. If Mr. Ford wants to reduce the price by 2 cents a liter overnight, he merely applies the tax, assuming that it's $1.21 a liter. In other words, forget the cap and trade, just cap the price at which HST is applied to any current price.
He says without him, gas would hit $2 a liter next summer. Is that in any way possible?
No. You know, there's a tipping point where the consumer starts to back off. There's no way it's going to hit $2 a liter.
Francis, Ford's plan would mean $1.2 billion in lost revenue. We should also mention the price of gas not expected to change tonight in Toronto, although we're looking for a 1 cent increase on Friday, which will bring us close to $1.40 a liter.
Well, it was once a must-have tech gadget, but the BlackBerry phone, what is that? All but dead, isn't it?
I know. It was only a decade ago when we all had our Blackberries on us.
We all wanted one. We craved them.
Yeah. And, boy, I still kind of miss the keyboard, I guess, Francis. But,
you know,
it's the end of the road, I think, for the BlackBerry phone in many ways. New numbers today show BlackBerries account for only 3% of smartphones out there. Of course, the advent of the iPhone and the subsequent advent of the Google Android platform really sunk the BlackBerry phone ship. Now, the company has made great strides in transitioning itself into more of a software company, and we're seeing the improvements it's made by looking at its stock price. BlackBerry shares up 5.7% this year, up more than 7% over the past 12 months. But as far as the actual phones are concerned, Francis, they're a relic now.
They're like a coaster. You can put your drink on it.
I think I do have a few in the old sock drawer, as a matter of fact.
So it's not cheap to live in Toronto, let alone New York City. And that's what makes this next story so incredible. So it's been revealed, and is this true, that an actress lived in a Manhattan apartment for decades, only paying $28 a month in rent?
$28 a month. Frances, her name was Patricia O'Grady. Mm-hmm. She moved, there she is. She moved to New York City in 1955 to pursue an acting career. She and two friends found this small two-bedroom apartment at the top of a commercial building in Greenwich Village, where apartments now go for $7,000 per month. The women ended up paying $16 each a month. They moved out. She ended up staying there by herself, though, for 60 years, Frances, paying just $28. She had a 50-year career in acting. Didn't make a lot of money, but she didn't have to, paying just $28 per month. She had no heat, no hot water in this apartment, no shower either. And she resisted offers to upgrade this apartment over the years, saying that she didn't deserve it, given what she was paying. She passed away in March of this year, Francis, and it just goes to show that some people there in New York City were still paying $28, the average two-bedroom here in Toronto, by the way, above $2,200 per month.
$28. That's incredible. Well, technology company LG is working on a drone phone, but most are skeptical that it will ever take flight.
Just a prototype at this point, but I want to show it to you because I thought the video was quite something. So here's the drone phone. It has a built-in rotors in it, so it can hover above your face while you're doing FaceTime. Look at that.
That's pretty
neat. Watching a movie on the couch, Francis.
Until it falls and smacks you in the face, though, Richard. But or worse, your wife who's sitting next to you, and then she's really upset you've spent all that money on it.
But, absolutely. Yeah. Not to mention the sound it would make, I suppose. Uh-huh. But it could also, you know, follow you as you're bungee jumping,
Right. Record
you. Also, if you got, you know, your friends there in the patio, it'll go up and take a big group selfie of you. Could also light the way home for you. If you're walking home in the dark, the phone could hover above you, light the sidewalk for you. And I love this final feature. You fall asleep with the phone in your bed, as we all do, and it would just take off by itself and go and charge itself once you're asleep, Francis. No word on if the drone phone is coming out. Some of the examples there aren't aerodynamically possible, but it shows what could be coming down the road, Francis.
Now, can it extend something to pick up your laundry off the floor and then maybe even do the laundry? Because that would be great.
And then I don't have to do anything ever again, which is fantastic.
That would be neat. Well, the royal wedding is expected to have a huge economic impact in the UK.
Sure is. They've crunched the numbers and they say that the wedding on Saturday will inject $1.4 billion into the UK economy, £300 million in tourism, £300 million in PR value. Everyone might look at London and say, I want to go have a visit. There's hundreds of millions of pounds in retail and restaurant spending expected. The fashion industry expected to get a boost as well. And the merchandise business really will benefit from this. They're selling all sorts of merchandise.
Well, you know, I was there for the last royal wedding, and you have to just buy a trinket, right? So I bought a little bell with the face. Now that's unbelievable. I would not buy that.
It's the Harry and Meghan swimsuit for $65, Francis. Yes. Or if maybe a coloring book is more your thing, an adult Harry and Meghan coloring book for $10. They say adult coloring reduces your stress levels. How about Harry and Meghan earrings?
Right?
Just $12 for those. Maybe your wife might like that. Royal wedding masks. We got to get some of these for Friday, maybe.
I've had one of those before. A Kate mask. I did bring one back. That's true.
Then there's the royal wedding condoms, Francis.
Oh.
Now, no joking. When you open this, it plays the Star Spangled Banner. No kidding.
What? The Star Spangled Banner. Okay.
The God Save the Queen.
Okay, I was going to say.
Wrong country. God Save the Queen will play when you open the royal wedding condoms for $17. Now we've seen it all, Francis.
Oh, God save the Queen and God help us all. All right. Thank you, Richard.
See you tomorrow.